And here we go. Everyone readying up real quickly, not much time being wasted. And we're going to be going live here. It's going to be insanity from Pakistan facing off against Synchronized Assault Wipeout. Is that the name again? Just going to... Yep, Synchronized Assault Wipeout. Love it. Unfortunately, it looks like the flag is not appearing for Nepal on top. But yeah. Valve keeps adding these maps to CSGO, so there are a few countries which aren't, because flags aren't there in the game yet. Quite rare. On Nepal, very unique flag they do have, so they're not there. But here we go. Berserk going live. Saw winning the pistol round. Going to be starting with CD side. They do have the kit on Vertex and the nade as well. Rusted guys going with the USP armor by. And Dealer's going to spot out the first man over near Palace. Smoke's going to come in to block off stairs and jungle, and a flashbang to follow up as well, and gonna be Vertex. He isn't CD spawn. They haven't smoked off CD spawn here, but they haven't pushed in. They just have a man inside the side. He's all alone. Critical. What are they trying to do here? Trying to perhaps go for trying to sell a fake, is what I'm assuming, or I'm not sure what's happening here. Gaddafi taking a ton of damage from the guys over in Palace. Vertex tapping away, and there's still two guys inside of Palace, and What are they doing? I'm not very sure about this. Vertex gonna get the kill. Gaddafi joins the party as well. Taran's gonna get the one kill, leaving it down to a 2v3 scenario. And it looks like one guy's timed out for insanity by the looks of it. Criminal. Oh, that's an unfortunate start for them. And he's the guy on the raid boss by. He's got a Tech 9 and the armor. Now Trans alone is gonna get a great shot into Vertex. And Gaddafi, can he survive for much more longer here? Oh, he's going to get his head ripped off. Gaddafi's going to fall. He's going to leave it down, all down to Airwave, who is coming in from CD spawn. And it's all down to Trans here. He's got to get the quad kill and the 1v3 clutch pretty much. And a bomb, though, it's dropped in the middle of nowhere. Airwave, does he know this? And they've spotted each other out. The timing is horrendous. And Airwave's going to tap away Trans. And that's going to be Saw winning the round there. Quite unfortunate for Insanity. They had the man just lag out just as they were about to execute. And the Valiant effort from Trans, not going to quite pan out. Assault is going to win that that clutch there. It's kind of weird. I'm assuming depending on the rule set is. I think the rule set is basically if a player times out or there's a disconnection before any damage is dealt out or anyone dies in the round, the round is restarted. If my rules knowledge are correct, so I'm assuming. I'm not really getting information here from the admins, but I'm assuming that we might have a restart of the pistol round coming out for Insanity, because he did get timed out before the round commenced, or rather before any action really started out here. So, yep, we might be having a restart as we wait for Criminal to rejoin back in the server. Quite unfortunate. But internet issues, there's nothing we can do about that. This neck break. And there was a pause for half an hour, and there were no breaks, nothing. I just had to keep talking nonstop, which was quite amazing, to be honest. But we're just waiting for any news to come in regarding the player timed out Criminal. And you just might be cutting to a very quick break. I'm just going to find out from the admin what is happening, and we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Let's not start. Alright, we're back. Very short break. So, just spoke to the admins. It looks like we will be restarting that pistol round. I think that's a fair decision they can make at this juncture. And we do have a criminal joining back. Looks like his PC died or something. But there you have it. Game's not live yet. Just waiting for the last player to join in so they can go for the restore the pistol round and go ahead with that. So, yeah. It did kind of look real off because Insanity were trying to go for this... For the play there, and the fact that their raid boss, the guy with the Tech 9 and armor, kind of timed out, you know, that was kind of unfortunate. But just taking a look here, looks like, yep, there we go. Criminal is gonna join back, and we should be resuming, or rather, yeah, we're gonna be restoring the game. Pretty cool feature. That's why I like Soulstorm. So, yeah, we're gonna starting from the beginning again. There we have it, and once more, this time Insanity. Let's see what I'm gonna try. Glock Train, HSB. With the smoke, I think he dropped the. I think he should have bought up a Tech 9 for his teammate. No. Not gonna buy a Tech 9. It's just gonna be the one smoke. It's gonna still have $500 in the kitty. And what? What is happening? What is happening? Okay, so it looks like I don't even. All right, it looks like they just got timed out again, but they are going to continue by the looks of it, which is unfortunate. Really unfortunate. They didn't seem to have any trouble the last time we played, though. But this is looking very, very tough indeed for Insanity, because they seem a little lost here. Yep, I was right. They did drop a Tech 9. I picked it up now, and it's going to be on shot. As we wait for them to come back again. And for the CTs, they got a double nade this time around. The kit on the Vertex as well. And they've got it pushed up mid so deep, Gaddafi. And he's going to get all the information that's required. They're trying to go for a B fake here. But he hears a guy running. Shots making a lot of noise over in B apartment. So he knows there's a one man there. And I don't think they're going to be falling for this. Meanwhile, there's going to be a push coming out in the A bomb site. Critical's going to get the first kill on the dealer. That's going to equalize things. We have Criminal back in the server as well. And yo, Gao, great shot from him. Picks up a double kill. Oh, okay. All right. I didn't see the first one. That's going to leave it down to shots and trans, but look at this positioning from Airwave. He spots a guy out. And shot, though. He's got a Tech 9, so he can still take this duel, but he's got to go for it fast before the reinforcements arrive for the CTs. He's going to tap away, not able to get the kill. He's going to be all down to trans once more in a 1v3. And the bomb is dropped inside of the B bomb site as well. This is going to be very tough. No time remaining as well, and Saw is going to win the round. Quite unfortunate. Trans are not going to get any bonus money either, so that is a horrendous start for the Pakistani team here. And the best thing they can do at this juncture right now is just force it up, try and equalize the money out, and you know, let's try and get the bomb down as well. And no, they're just going to go for a very light buy. Trans with the only Kevlar of the round, and Dealer X is going to spot the first man out. It's going to be Vertex, going to get the kill, however, but from awesome long range. And Dealer is trying to spray for all it's worth, gets a kill on the HSB. Lots of mana, just flicks across here, gonna get the kill, down to 3 points of health, but that's okay, as Gaddafi's gonna get on critical as well, leaving it all down to trans, 17 points of health, what could he do? Absolutely nothing, is what Dealer is gonna reply with. 3 points of health, just goes for the kill as well, picks up a triple kill that round. That's gotta be 2-0. It's Insanity, we'll be going for the double eco here. Didn't get the bomb down either time, so try and go for a double eco. I should be able to go for a comfortable buy in the 4th round. You do have a pause coming in once more. And all right, so it's going to resume. It looks like we're just clarifying things if Insanity do have a stand-in just in case Criminal times out again. But it's going to be again a few deagles, a few pistols this time around. and at least try to get the bomb down. And for Soth, that didn't lose a single man in the previous round, didn't go for any SMG buys, just going directly rifles and a swag 7 on airwave. Let's see if they are going to be able to make it work out. All across the map, other guys did C4 still drop near T-spawn. Shot is going to take the duel over in mid with Gaddafi. Gaddafi doing a lot of damage, but not able to get the kill. I think he might have heard a man over in the underpass. Oh, they're going for the boost here. Gaddafi tapping with a USP. Doesn't have to go for this duel. He has no need to go for this. Just have the deagles, a few, couple of P250s, the one tech 9. Just a couple of guys. Actually, three guys with armor, but just one tap on the head. And they can be completely decimated. And Dealer X is going to be seeing some action real quickly here. Three guys over in mid. Spots a man in palace as well. And he's stacking some damage. Little, iffy spray there. Six bullets remaining. Gaddafi's going to join the party. He's going to get the first kill on his shot. But now they have an interesting boost. Waiting for the peek from over from window and airwave. He's pushed in pretty deep into B apartments. He's getting the information as well. They still have a man over near underpasses. Dealer's going to find criminal. Leaving it down to HSP, Trans, and Critical to do something about this. Vertex going to spot the man over near cave. Critical, not able to get the kill. It's going to get taken out. Vertex is going to find Trans. That's going to be the last man left alive. It's going to be HSP. And just with the deagle. And he is going to get taken down once again. Another flawless round coming out from Saw. So these are some pretty good anti-eco rounds. They haven't died at all. So that's going to really bolster their economy going into the Insanity's buy round. Of Insanity. What are they going to do? And then we have, take a look at the buy. AKs all around. A few Molotovs. Criminal, the only man with no resources to speak of. That was a nade. Pretty deep. It's not going to do any damage from airwave. He's still going to be blinking that shotgun. As the smokes are going to rain. And it looks like they're going to be committing into this B bomb site here. And airwave is going to need a lot of help very soon. Gonna miss the first shot. HSP is gonna instantly take his head off. And Gao, G-O-W, gonna fall back. He's gonna get spotted out. Sprays away. Not able to get a kill. Critical's gonna take him down. There's gonna be a B-bomb site in control with the terrorists. Now Vertex with the Molotov. But this is gonna be a pretty tough retake here for the CTs. As Trans waiting for Gaddafi. Gaddafi, a little careless there. Gonna get taken down. And Vertex, he's around the corner. Goes for the spray. Gonna get the first kill on the critical. There's still four more to find. As his teammate is coming in, Dealer, and it's going to be the last one left alive. Dealer, not able to get a single kill. A shot is going to get finish off the final two frags, and we do have one more pause coming in by the looks of it, as Criminal has timed out once more. And yeah, I think at this juncture, they just might be going for the stand-in. But Insanity, going to win the first buy round. And that was a very iffy hold coming out from Saul. And Insanity, very, very basic B-smoke execute, working out for them perfectly. I'm just going to take a look at what the admins are saying at the moment. It looks like if we'll be actually having... Let me take a look here. It looks like we might actually be having the stand-in coming in by the looks of it. Yeah, just waiting for the stand-in to come in by the looks of it for Insanity. We do have Criminal rejoining back again. This guy has been got a feel for him. He's been plagued by connectivity issues. As it's gonna be another eco run coming out from the team for Pakistan. What are they gonna do though? They have the deagle. HSP gonna be the first casualty of the round, and Criminal is just well at this juncture. I'd say if you have a stand in, get him out. Because he's just completely, you know, it's pointless having him around at the moment here. He's not able to do anything. He's just getting lagged out all the time. Vertix has been spotted by Critical. Auto's going to come in. Vertix going for the duels. Actually, it's going to be Critical going for the duel. He wins it. But he's going to be alone now in a 1v4. It's going to be almost impossible. As they have a nice cross-wiping setup, he's going to get a nice tap on a dealer. Not able to get a second, the third kill rather, for the round for him. As Zero's going to take him down. And that's going to be... Uh, 5v1, and looks like Insanity, they're kind of out of pauses right now. Now that's kind of unfortunate, but yeah, rules are rules, I guess. And for Insanity, yeah, they should call out their stand-in at this juncture. 5-1 down already. And to be honest, I thought, you know, they would be, well, the slight favorites, although I had no clue but saw. And right now, yeah, like, not so impressed so far. Just getting a little lucky, a little aggression coming out here. Airwave gonna start spraying early on. And he's gonna get taken down by HSB, and it's gonna be Gao replying back with a frag of his own, but Critical is gonna take him down. And, oh, nice shot for Vertix. This guy's been landing some sweet shots with the AWP here. It's a 5v4. They can't afford to lose rounds like this. Dexter peeks around the corner, finds shot. It's all down to Critical here. He's gonna get the first. He's gonna get a second kill. No, he won't. Dealer's gonna take him down. And there's gonna be a defuse coming in, and another round for Saw to make it 6-1. And Insanity. Ooh, man. Kinda sucks. Kinda sucks. I wonder if they have a Pakistani version of BSNL. BSNL, as I like to call it. Maybe it's called PSNL or something. Maybe that's what Criminal is using. I mean, yeah, most of us watching here, and we're from India, but yeah, I think all of us share some common issues when it comes to internet connectivity and whatnot. Critical is going to get the first kill here. Airwave being very, very adventurous, still duking it up with a USP, and he's doing a great job holding fort, waiting for his rotation to come in from his teammates. Trans is going to get Airwave, but now in a very unenviable position. That is a 1v3. Maybe that's actually a 1v4, pretty much. He's got to get the clutch, the quad clutch. He wants to win this for his team. And Saw playing perfectly. Trans, great shot to Gaddafi, bringing it back to a more reasonable scenario for him. 2v1, he's announcing himself. Does some damage though on the Vertix, but Vertix with the tag and dealer to finish him off. 7-1. And yeah, this is quite unfortunate. I really feel bad for this. Like, 5v4 is just not the way it's supposed to be. And right now, I'm just listening. I'm trying to get some information, but it looks like they haven't really... they haven't called their stand-in yet. They haven't got Criminal back yet, so I'm not sure what they're thinking of. Maybe Insanity just thinking that the CD side is much more stronger right now, but I don't know. Critical? First mana goes for the spray battle. Dealer's gonna win it. And Trans is gonna fall as well almost immediately to Gaddafi. HSB would reply back, but it's alone now. 1v4 once again. Oh, great shot from HSB! And he gives himself a small little chance. Picks up Vertix as well. And it's gonna be... Wow, this is massive. He's got to get the ace here to clutch it. Going for the duels. Spots out the first man. Continues going for the spray. Now there's a man over in jungle. And oh, HSB! This man is just taking matters into his own hands. Not able to get the clutch in the end, though. That would have been an ace clutch. Nice try. That was huge, dude. That was absolutely huge. And Insanity. Oh. I do feel for them. I do really feel for them. They are trying here. They haven't given up. They are trying, but yeah, 4v5 is not going to be easy by any stretch of the imagination. That was absolutely brilliant. A great try from HSP. I mean, even if they lose this game, like, I would have nothing but the utmost respect for these guys if they, you know, fight as hard as they're fighting right now. Gaddafi. Oh, Trant. Great shot. Great shot on Gaddafi. That's gotta be make it a 4v4. So, great opening here. Just speaking purely from raw aim, from whatever little I've seen so far, it looks like Insanity are just so much more better right now compared to Saw. But yeah, the fact is, and 4v5 is always going to be a problem. Shot and HSP reply back with two quick kills of their own, leaving it down to Critical and HSP to clutch this out against Gao. And Airwave is down to 15 points of health. He's coming from CD spawn. He had been spotted earlier when he got trans. And Gao spots out the man over in Tetris. He's going to get take the duel, takes out Critical. He's going to stick it though. Not able to stick it. HSP's going to get the kill. The man himself. And no time remaining. Airwave is just down 15 points of health. He knows he's going to do nothing about this. And Insanity are going to win the second round here. 4v5 as well. These guys are just playing their hearts out at the moment. Alright, so just hearing from the admin that they are trying to get the stand-in to come in, I guess. Not sure what's happening. All right, so looks like I'm just talking to Insanity, and it looks like, yeah, they don't have a stand in either. This is just heartbreaking. This is so heartbreaking for these guys. And they were so promising the first game I saw them, but you know what? If they continue hitting those shots, especially like how HSP has been just going ham, you never know. You never know. There was this 4v5 game that Brutality played. Was it Brutality or was it Neckbreak? I forgot. It was a 4v5 game they played. Not, it wasn't Neckbreak. I think it was the mix in Virtual Impact, and there was Zulk and Machine Gun, and they played against an Indonesian or Singaporean team, I forget, where they played 4v5, and it came down to 13 and 16-14. It was such a tight game, so, you know, just because of Zulk and Machine Gun. Raw M. HSB, this guy doesn't give a damn. He is just picking heads, asking no questions, just destroying this. This 4C buy coming out from the... It's pretty much an eco from the CTs, but still HSB landing those crazy shots. Quad kill from the man. And it looks like these guys are just gonna go for it. 4v5, they don't care. Just gonna go for this. I swear, if they pull this off 4v5... I'm just going to be very, 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 very surprised. And HSB right now. Like, just make out, they seem angry. He's taking the fight. Airwave is going to finally stop HSB, because that man is an absolute beast. It's a triple man stack over in the A bomb site. Insanity, they should take things a little slower here. Gao's going to take on Trans as well, just with the Deagle. They have an AK-47 and Airwave as well. So, shot and Critical. They're going to come up big here. And let's see what they can do. The CTs are split up. And if Shot can't play this perfectly, oh, the vent's not broken though, so that's gonna announce his presence. He could have tried going for the CT flank, but that's so risky and Critical. Shot's cleared out every angle over near jungle, playing it very safe from CT spawn. Oh, an arrow just waiting in the edge. Shot's gonna fall. It's gonna leave it all down to Critical in a 1v4, but he's no HSB. His verdict's gonna take him down. 9-3 is Saw. Managed to win that force buy. And we do have criminal joining the party here. His ping is still atrocious. But what he could do right now is at least be the bank for the team. $16,000 is going to drop a lot of rifles to his teammates. At least a couple of his teammates. And 9-3. It's not over yet. It's not over till the fat lady says so. And criminal. Just taking a look at his ping. He's having an abysmal ping. Spiking all over the place. I got a feel for the guy. But it looks like hopefully criminal's ping should subside a little bit and he should be able to play, because right now HSB is single-handedly going Nico mode here. It's like watching mouse boats all over again. And Gaddafi in the sight. Smoke's raining out. The T-Squad haven't executed yet. They're taking a sweet time. They spar out Gaddafi. He's alone here. He's not going to get any backup anytime soon. Tran's going to get the kill. Dealer pushing into the smoke. He's going to reply back real quickly. And that's Danger Man taking out the equation. HSB is going to fall. But the smoke is slowly but surely dissipating. And Dealer just spraying there. Oh! Wow, they took forever to get the man down. But Insanity, why did they have to wait so long? And Critical, he had a smoke as well. He could have used it. Shot is going to get the one kill. But Airwave is going to win that particular duel. He's going to leave it down. Sorry, that's here. Critical is going to lose that duel. He's going to leave it all down to Shot in a 1v3. Can't do anything. Dealer's going to take him down. And that was a little suspect play from Insanity. They had an extra smoke. They should have re-smoked off something. They waited a long time for the, you know, after the smokes were deployed to go into the site. And they should have known, you know, it's going to dissipate any moment. And that's what happened. The C4 getting taken down. Criminal. He's finally back here. Trans gonna open things up. Trans going HSB mode at the moment. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, Criminal's ping has finally normalized. And Trans, he is so hungry for more kills. He's got a triple kill already. Airwave down to 1 point of health. Just need to toss a pin in his way and he's gonna fall. And it's all down to Gao inside a jungle to do some damage if he can. But the bomb is gonna get planted. Insanity at the very end here of the first half might be able to make something out of this. Nice shot at the Trans. Trans really hungry for more. Shot's gonna find Airwave. And it's down to the last man left alive. It's gonna be Gao. His taps away. HSP's gonna fall. 3v2 here. But it's Critical waiting for him right behind him. Gets the kill. Picks up the AK. 10-4 is Insanity. At one point, it looked like a game that was gonna run away from them. But they are clawing back. And they manage to win 5 rounds on the T side. And especially if Criminal's internet's not gonna act up anymore, they do have a very, very solid chance here. It is a T side on Mirage. Better than mine. Trans once again just opening things up. This man is just walking in naked into the sights. He's just going in hard, raw, and deep spots. The second man, Verdict's gonna fall as well. And he is just winning this duel single-handedly. He's not taking a sliver of damage yet. He's done a ton of damage to Gaddafi as well. Gaddafi's gonna get the kill, but he's so low, and so is Gao. HSP's kinda low as well, but definitely advantage to the terrorists as the bomb is gonna get planted on the B bomb side. And Trans single-handedly coming to the A side and just decimating the CTs. That's gonna be it. HSP waiting for Gaddafi to peek out. He's gonna get the first kill. And now Gao and Airwave. Airwave's gonna find HSB. And Criminal waiting for Gao to peek around that corner. And Airwave, last man left alive in a 1v3. There's no saving at this point. He's got to get the bomb down. Sorry, he's got to get it defused. I'm sorry. And they just need to play this smart. They know he was in CT. They knew he was in CT. There's no one's gonna come in through apartment. So, Critical. A little bit of miscommunication. Good have been called out. 10 to 5. As Saw. We'll get the 10 rounds, but Insanity, man. The fact they got 5 kills. Sorry, 5 rounds. That is so impressive, considering they played 4v5 for the majority of that half. And HSB and Trans pretty much going carry mode here. And now that we have Criminal back, let's see what they're gonna do. And this buy from Insanity. This buy. No kits, no nades, nothing. It's just armor and USPs and a 1P250, a P2000 in the mix. They are so confident here, but it's going to be HSB getting a little too aggressive, a little too greedy. And look at this shot! Picks up a double kill, gets a triple kill, and just walking into the slaughter like blind lambs. And Shot is just waiting there, racking up the headshots, and that's going to leave it down to Dealer and Gao to do something special about it. Dealer's going to get the kill on Criminal, leaving down a 3v2, but pushing into the smoke there, one by one by one. Oh man, Shot's going to fall to Gao finally, and Gao in the 1v3 is going to get the first kill, but Transit critical. Still alive, they got all the health in the world to play with as well. C4 is dropped as well. Gao's gonna pick it up quietly. Spotter out the man, and critical is just gonna decapitate Gao. 10-6 is insanity to win that. And look at this, one by one into his crosshair, and he just picks up 3 headshots just like that. A hat trick of headshots. And well then, that's a way to start a round. Calm, controlled taps. HSB with the Scout. 2 SMGs, it's MP7 and P90. And 1 Swag-7 in the mix. And just the 1 rifle that's going to be the FAMAS and the Nepalese team. They are not going to waste much time here. Looks like they're just going to push into the A-bomb. Submit Trans is waiting. He picks up a double kill. Criminal gets 1 kill. Gao and Gaddafi with a couple of kills apiece. But it's going to be all down now to Dealer X. Alone in a 1v3, just with the CZ, hiding in the smoke. For how long? How much longer can he hide? Not for much more longer. As Critical is going to find him. 10-7. And they are able to, they win the round, losing just 2 men, but they should be pretty comfortable with that. Not able to get the bomb down, so Saw will have to go for another full-on dry eco here. And Insanity are angry. And looks like we actually have a stand-in coming in here for Insanity. Criminal, that's not having any luck. So we do have a stand-in coming in for Insanity. Jaw, let's take a look. Yep, he is in the team. And unfortunately, he joined a little too late, so no money for him. But look at this push coming out from the CT. That's going to be the guy pushing into B apartments. And he knows this. He knows there's no one in the B apartments. The HSB is pushing all the way to T-spawn. This could be a complete, utter massacre here. Because they just have Glocks and P250s. Jaws may going to make a small little jump there. He's just got a Deagle, no armor as well, so he might just get taken down. But he's going to get the kill on the Dealer. We're going to drop down below Palace. He's still going to go for the duel here. Airwave's going to get the kill, but he's so down to health, 4 points of health, and they are just going to get slaughtered down here. But as CDs come charging around the corner, Critical's going to find one. HSP transits all over in a split second, as Insanity is just going to eco bash them. And HSP with parting few shots into the corpse. One of the Fallen Saw members, Insanity, 2 rounds shy now of tying things up. They have the AWP, the big green, in the hands of HSB as well. And ladies and gentlemen, we do have a fight in our hands. For the T's. Few Molotovs. Gao, great shot on the jaw. I wonder if he just came running in from somewhere. I wonder if he even had time to warm up. As it's going to be the opening kill going the way of Saw here. Let's see if they can do something. If they can do something about it, though. C4 still all the way over in T spawn. HSB with the AWP over in mid, but Gaddafi has made his way over the mid boxes while the remaining 3 members, the other 3 members, that's Vertex, Dealer, and Gao, gearing up to go for this A execute. Airway is going to fall back from all the way from B apartments where he was watching for the flank. He's going to pick C4 as well. They do have a number of smokes, 4 smokes still with them, a couple of Molotovs as well. So they're going to be going for this A setup play. Gaddafi over in mid, making a little bit of noise. Smoke's going to smoke off window, and he is trying to flank, probably go for the flank from mid, as it's going to be the A play coming out here from the terrorist. Counterflash is coming in from the CTs as well. It's going to delay this push for a bit more. No smoke for jungle, though. That's a very surprising play. They had enough smokes. Go for it. Transit HSB going to get a couple of kills. It's critical. Peek's around the corner. Not going to get a good kill, in fact. Gao's going to reply back, but HSB is there to avenge his teammate. It's going to be all down to Gaddafi. Going to get the first kill on HSB, but Trans run top of the ticket booth, going to take him down, and they might be able to salvage the AWP as well. There we go. Insanity, one round shy now of tying things up at 10-10 with Saw. And for Saw, though, the eco coming out here. And I don't know why I didn't smoke off jungle. If you're gonna go for it, I mean, and execute, just go for it full-fledged. Couple of deagles, couple of Peter 50s, one Glock and a prayer on the lips of the Nepalese team as they are planning to push into the A site once more. Little surprise why they haven't, why they're really, really adamant about trying to get into this A bomb site where they really haven't had much success so far. Rather, I would say, you know, try and try a luck over the B bomb site at least once. As we do have all of them gathering up, and for the CTs, they have a 3 Molotovs as well, and they can just stop any push coming out from Saw. But Saw just waiting, they're taking the time, waiting for perhaps a CT to push in, but Insanity not going to have any of it. They know there should be a Nico. Jaw taking a little bit of damage, but that should be okay. He's taking his time switching his nade to the incendiary, and that's going to prevent the guy from Palace from peeking out. Meanwhile, Tran's going to make contact with Airwave. Airwave's going to fall. You know this guy in Palace as well. Tran spots out another man over near A slope. And here they come charging out into the A bomb site by the looks of it. No, they're not. And Dealer with a great shot on the jaw. But Tran is still alive. This guy has been an absolute beast. Not going to get a second kill as Gaddafi. Dealer are going to get a couple of quick kills. And the bomb hasn't crossed yet. This is the problem. They don't have any utility to play with. No smokes, no flashes whatsoever. And now Dealer's going to pick up the M4 from the fallen guy in HSP. Great shot. Goes for the flick shot as well. Not able to land it. Gao's going to take him down. And all of a sudden, how did this even happen? It's going to be shot. And he's got the shotgun. He's just got a Mag 7 to play with. And this is going to double peek him. But a running shot on the Dealer X. He knows where the last man is. Going to get go for the first kill. Yes, he is going to clutch it out with a jumping headshot. Nonetheless, because they really didn't have any time to go for the plant there. But so much damage being dealt out by Saw. And Insanity had to bleed and sweat for that round. And I really did think Saw might just take it. Jesus Christ. I pretty much forgot how to English there. Full buy coming out from Saw this time around again. The AWP on Vertex. He was pretty handy with it on his on the CT side. And look at where Jaw's pushing. This could be massive. He spots out the first man. Not able to continue to spray. Gao's going to take him down barely. Pretty much unscathed from that particular deal. That's going to leave it to the man advantage you saw once more. I still can't get over the fact that Shot clutched that with a Swag 7. And I love it. He still has a Swag 7 to play with. He still hasn't. He could have easily picked up some other gun. But instead, he is really, really comfortable playing with this with a shotgun. That's what I assume. Spots out the man over in apartments. Yes, they are once again gearing up for this A play. Tran should spot the smoke coming into the A bomb site right about now. There we go, flashes coming in. The Molotov coming in from the CTs. That's going to prevent any early push here. Tran's tucked himself in the corner. And look at the Firewalker here. That's going to be Gao charging up. But Tran's going to get the kill. The Molotov doing a ton of damage. They are not waiting for the Molotov to get extinguished. Aero's going to get the kill of Tran as well. HSP with a great shot. But it's going to get flanked from behind by Dealer. Critical's there to reply back as well. Leaving it down. The last two men left life. It's going to be Verdix and Gaddafi. Verdix with the AWP. It's so low in health. 22 points of health. Both of them inside the side as well. Shot though. Still with the Swag 7. And Critical. Great shot to Verdix. Going to leave it all on Gaddafi. Cannon clutches out. The nade is going to rain in. Bomb is going to get planted. It's going to take a little bit of damage though. Critical? Did he not spot the man out though? And Shot is coming in from connector. Still with the Maxim. And Gaddafi's got himself in a great position. He's gonna spot the first man out. Gets a kill. Is he gonna get a second kill? No, it's not Shot. Finally swaps his gun out to the AK-47 and gets the kill as well. As it's gonna be Insanity surviving just with one man. But they are gonna be on in the lead here after a long, long time indeed. 11-10 to the team from Pakistan. This time around, Saw, full, let me just take a look at the rounds. Yeah, max money bonus. They haven't won a single round the T-side so far. And Gaddafi with the armor and Glock. Miss by coming in, maybe just drop for his teammate, but that's kind of Yeah, dealer's got 2,200. Oh yeah, there is an AK. Sorry, I thought we were just running around with the Glock. So they do have the AK and Gaddafi. Still 11-10, very very close. As Airwave is going to get the first kill. HSP replying by real quickly, but Trade's coming in real quickly over here in mid. And it's going to be the CTs coming off the worst for wear. As once again, the man advantage firmly with the team from Nepal. Rodix, not going to spot the man over in mid. He's going to fall back. C4 still over in T-spawn as it looks like the terrorist. Again, very slow pace style coming out from Saw. And this time around, a little change of pace here. They are making their way over to the B bomb site. And Vertex waiting for Trans to go for the peak. Trans is going to fall. The shot's going to come up absolutely massive here. He's going to go huge. As they just have 26 seconds remaining on the clock, they are going to be committing here into the B bomb site. A flashback comes out. He's going to get the first. He's going to get a second. No, he's up. Look at them. They're so low, though. As Gao and Gaddafi are internally bleeding. They're alive support. And it's all down to Jaw. And Vertex is waiting for him with open arms and his AWP, and it's going to decimate him. 11-11, Assault get their first round on board here on T-side, tying things up once more. So this is not done and dusted quite yet. Insanity will be forced to go for Nika. The money kind of got broken there, and Saw have a great opportunity to once again be in the lead here. He's got to be kicking himself there. He almost could have got a complete three-man spray down. Aggressing into T-spawn. Dealer, ooh. Took too much damage there. He's going to survive in trance, missing each and every shot. And Dealer going full Neo mode, dodging bullets. And he's going to survive in 8 points of health, but that's okay. He's done his job. And HSB, hello, Vertex. The one dig is indeed alive. And HSB, he's been spotted out. Going to go for the repeat here, but he's getting flanked from underpass as well. Gaddafi is going to end him. And not going to get his hands on that op. Jaw, last man left alive. He's going to get the one parting shot. As he's going to be Saw coming ahead once more. 12-11. And the spray by Dealer. How did he survive this? These shots from Trans, though? Nice spray control in the end. And that's going to be the scores. Very close. Look at HSP and Trans, man. 22 frags apiece. These guys are just going beast mode. And for Saw as well, we have Dealer and 22 frags. So this is a very, very tight game indeed. And Shot, still with the Mag 7. And Trans is going to open things. Actually, Trans is going to take down Airwave. Well, HSP is going to find Vertex this time, winning the duel. And some aggression over in Palace working out for the CTs. This is one thing which I really enjoyed watching yesterday against... The day before yesterday, I guess. MOB, Make or Break, where they played Mirage, and they played it really, really well on the CT side, especially aggressing a lot, trying to make sure that... you know, the T's are always kept on their toes. And I wish I saw a little bit of from Insanity as well, as they have Spyrod shot, but a great shot on the Gaddafi. He's going to get the kill, and he's going to position himself in such a way that he might not be expecting him here. Nades raining in, flashbacks pouring to the B apartments. 45 seconds on the clock. They have so much time to still work with, though, but Dealer's going to get the one kill, but a bomb is dropped inside the B bomb site, and all the CTs are waiting for them, but Dealer is not done quite yet. Spots another man over near benches. In a 2v3, he is finally going to fall to Jaw, and it's all down to Gao, who can't do anything. His Trans is going to decapitate him. 12-12, Insanity themselves bring it back, bringing it to 12-12 here. Scores are tied once more, and for Saw, they should be able to buy up here. Yep, just going to go for this. Might be seeing some Deagles, some Tech Nines. Three AKs, a couple of Deagles, and we've seen what they can do with the... We've seen what it can do with the Deagle, though. And HSP just waiting for them and just feeding him the kills. Airway's going to fall. No one to trade for him. Just Deagle lost. So they have that going for them. HSB drops down. This man is just feeling it at the moment. Absolutely insane, living up to his team's name. And already two men to the good for Insanity. He's just walking around uncontested, just picking people left, right, and center. That's an AK taken down, taken out of the equation as well, and it is an underpass. And they do have a man who's trying to probably go for the AK. Yep, there's going to be the AK getting picked up, so they do have the true rifle, but Trans is waiting for Dealer. Dealer just walking out alone, and this is not working out for Saw here. You just can't go in one by one by one and just get picked off without anyone trading for you. It's going to be very painful. HSB, another nice shot onto Gaddafi, leaving it all down to Gao, alone, without the C4. Shot spotted him out as well. And what could it do here? 1v4. The C4 has been spotted by the CT as well over near T-spawn. Jaw spotted the C4. He's going to be sitting on it and actually going for the hunt here. Jaw hungry for the kills and done a ton of damage, but Gao gets a headshot. But yeah, that's pretty much all he can do here. Unless Insanity decided to completely throw it and shot. Just playing around, just jumping around. Gao's trapped. There's no way out here. There's absolutely no way out. And Trans just waiting for him. There you have it. 13-12. And Saw are pretty broke right now. That's going to enable Insanity to get one more run closer to closing out what has been, well, an interesting match. Well, you know what they say, when all else fails, when you don't have any weapons to play with, on Mirage, buy a couple of smokes, couple of flashes, YOLO B, don't stop, Sukabliet. And that's exactly what Saw is going to do when shot with the Swag 7. Not a great gun for an Eco Bash, because it's just going to jump in, and it takes a while for each shot to get rattled off. And shot, interesting positioning from him, going to enable him to drop down the second he spots the first man. Taking the time though. They have a couple of smokes, the one flashbang. But I don't think the flashbang is really gonna. Oh, it's gonna blind shot. And he's gonna drop down. But it's still blind. And Airwave and Dealer running and gunning. And two Deagle headshots out of nowhere. But HSP still alive. And this man has been an absolute revelation. As long as he's alive, it's not gonna be easy. They have the man advantage. They don't have the weaponry though. When HSP goes for the shot. Vortex is going to find Trans as well. This is looking very, very hard. Need for Insanity around that. They had no business losing. Jaw's going to get the kill. And HSB is going to reply back with a frag of his own. Leaving down a 2v2 here. And they have a smoke. They might just stick it here. They don't have anything else. But Gao is going to get the first kill on the Jaw. And Gaddafi going to pick off HSB. And out of nowhere, Saw to snatch it back again. 13-13. The Deagles just working out. And what is happening here? What in God's name is happening? This is sheer insanity. Scores are tied once more. And would you look at it, Insanity's money is kind of all over the place as well. They will be going for a kind of a mixy buy. They do have a couple of guys with a little bit of money. So a scout coming out on HSB, you know, CZ, 5-7, Ramon Trans, as they would look to inflict what Saw just did right now. But those were some nasty shots just with Deagles. Four Deagle kills and just one rifle kill which they got. So it's not over yet. It's not over yet. They have gone for the B stack, Insanity, and for Saw, luckily for them, they are going to be executing into the A bomb site where there's just one man waiting. That, of course, is a shot. And it just has a CZ. 24 bullets, 5 men. And he's going to get swamped very, very soon. Oh, the timing is just so off. Gonna spot the first man out. Kicks on Gaddafi. He could pick up the AK if he wants to. He spots the first man as well, and yet that's exactly what it's gonna do. Picks up the AK, and now Saw will be executing here. They don't need to go for these duels. Use the Molotovs. Use your smokes. Just use your smokes. Vert is going to find critical, and it's shot, but a great shot on Dealer once more, leaving it down to man advantage to CTs, and why aren't they using the smokes? I don't understand. I don't understand why they're not using the smokes. Verdict's going to protect this team, and as a bomb is going to get planted. But look at Trance coming in, not able to get the killers. Air is going to take his head off. It's going to be down to Shot and HSB, and Shot with the AK-47, not able to do much. And Nate's going to rain in. He's down 24 points of hell. HSB is going to come in with a scout. He's taking a ton of damage as well. Goes for a flick shot, not able to land it. Air is going to take on Shot, leaving it all down to HSB with the AK-47, 56 points of hell, and is going to decide to just get it out of there, save the AK-47, and fight another day, or rather another round of Saw. They still have two smokes with them. And they didn't have to go for those duels. They didn't have to go for those fights. I don't understand what they're doing there. You got two smokes, guys. Three more flashes. They haven't even used it even now. Why wouldn't you use your smokes? Why would you have to make it so tough for you guys? Oh boy. That triggers me so hard sometimes. So aren't playing bad at all. Just that, you know, they're just small little things, small little mistakes that... They're not even small mistakes. You got two smokes. Use the bloody smokes. And Insanity. It's going to be a job with the kind of a... screwed up nade. Continue spraying through the smoke. Not going to find anyone. Meanwhile, once again, they are... they're going for a very basic default here. To keep Airwave over in B apartments. He's going to watch for the flank. They have Dealer over in mid, watching for any CD pushing up mid. And, you know, three guys over near A Slope and Palace, who will be... waiting to go for the inevitable A play. Once again, same thing. Dealer's going to come in flanking from mid in the connector. Aero is going to make haste and come in all the way to A slope here, where Vertex, Airwave, and Gaddafi are going to be setting up their smokes. And Gao over from Palace. So a very, very predictable setup. They've been doing this multiple times. And this time around, we might actually see a few smokes. Yes? No? No? Yep, smokes out there, but HSP's gonna get the kill. And Jaw is just coming alive from beneath. Vertex and Dealer replying by real quickly, but Jaw, a triple kill. This guy is just going absolutely ham. Gonna leave it down to Dealer. He's been the man to watch for Saw, but he's gotta clutch us out here and get map point. The nade could just completely decimate Jaw. Jaw so low and held, but Shot with the AWP takes him down. That's gonna be 14-14. The scores are tied. We are going down to the absolute wire here. And Jaw, this is some great, great frags coming out from the man. Great spray control. Picks up the double. And the triple in the end there with a headshot nonetheless. And quick trades. But it is going to be the scores at 14-14. HSP with the AWP once more. He's gonna rotate all the way back to the B bomb side. But once again, if you look at how they're playing, it's pretty much the same thing. Just swapping some players out. Three guys over near the A site waiting for the execute. Vertex over mid marking for any early push from Insanity. Dealer marking over near B apartments. And now they're all gonna fall back. They're gonna keep Vertex over in mid, or maybe Dealer X gonna be mid. Then they're gonna be going for the A execute, or maybe not. This time around, it looks like they're gonna be heading for this B play here, where Dealer is pushing pretty deep. He's making some noise over in B apartments. Where Shot is alone. But this time he's got a swag 7 again. And Shot is just flirting with death here. He's just flirting with death. Shot with a jumping shot. Not gonna land it though. Finally gonna get Airwave through the edge of the door as well. Of the doorway rather. He spots multiple people coming out here. He's still just running and jumping. And what is this? The triple kill from Shot. And they are just getting decimated here. Our Saw. This is just a tragedy for these guys. And Shot, 29 points of felt. He is just untouched, unscathed. He should have been dead by now. As Trans has gone find Vertex all down to Gao. And Shot is still going for the jumping kills. 8 seconds remaining on the clock, and this has just fallen apart indeed for Saw. and they have no money. This was everything for them. They have no money. If Gao loses this gun, there we go. He lost a round after the time ran out as well. So this is it. Saw have nothing to play with. They got no money whatsoever. They got nothing to play with right now. $2,000 in four players and $200 in Gao. There's nothing. He can't even buy a pistol. He can just buy a flashbang. And the rest of his teammates can't drop him anything either. It's just, yeah, he's gonna buy a flashbang and that's it. And they have a few smokes though, but against a fully armored Insanity, it's gonna be very hard indeed. And Saw, oh man, heartbreak for them. They were so close. They were so close. And just that Mag 7, especially from that range, just decimating them. Are we gonna see an overtime? I doubt it. I really doubt it. Not with this buy. Gao's got a Glock, for crying out loud. No armor either. And HSP is marking a cave. And look at where this man's pushed up as well. Shot. He's hungry for more with a shotgun. He's creeped in all the way to be a pub. They know it's an A play. And he hears them as well. Go for the first shot. Gets and they are taking so long to reply back. Shot is re-peeking again and again and again. Gaddafi's gonna fall. Arev so low as well. And now the T's, they need to decide here. 51 seconds remaining on the clock. They need to commit. They need to make something happen. Trans to spot the first man out in mid, but Airwave takes him down with a great shot. But HSB is waiting here. The man himself. This guy has been an absolute beast. With 35 seconds remaining on the clock, though, it looks like the T's are going to be committing here to the B-bomb side. No, you don't have to jump into the smoke. No, don't jump into the smoke. Not alone. A shot is going to deal out one death onto the T's. I don't even know what I'm saying at this moment right now. Dex is going to get the kill. It's going to leave it down to the last man. Last two men here. D-Lorex and Gao to make the play. And it's going to be HSB with the op. He's going to pick up the first kill. All down. The last man left alive. Gao with a shotgun. Swag 7. Nothing he can do. Critical's going to end him. 16-14 as Insanity bring it back with an absolute masterclass performance in the end there. But Jesus Christ, that was a close game. And considering that Insanity were playing 4v5 for the majority of the T side. Props to them, man. Props to them. HSB, look at the 32 kills on the man. He has been the MVP for me. Absolutely stellar shots from him. Incredible T side, considering they were man down for so many rounds. And he just went absolutely ham. Like, kudos to him, man. I mean, he was absolutely brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Trans as well, not taking away anything away from him. He really held his own as well. Look at the impact rating on... it came down to the wire. Impact rating was 16 on HSP. You don't see that often, especially when all 30 rounds are played out. 30 kills on the man. Trans at 27. 23 on shot. And even Critical doing his bit as well. Unfortunately, that Criminal wasn't... You know, he had massive internet issues. But then Jaw coming in as a stand-in, doing his work as well. Pretty decent KDR. He did his job. He didn't do anything fancy, but he did his job. And for Saw, though, you know, brilliant effort from them as well. D-Lorex especially was a pick of the lot. Absolutely brilliant play coming up from him. Gao as well, some great shots, especially those that Deagle round when they won that eco round, the B-bombs. That spectacular performance from him. And yeah, just take a look at the round impacts from the game. And that just tells the story. 7 opening kills a piece on HSP and Trans. That's 14 rounds, the opening kills. Or the entry kills went to HSP and Trans. That to two players. That is absolutely insane. And even the trade game, right? HSP with 7 trade kills. I mean, this guy, it's pretty much his performance. But then again, 16-14. So far, the closest game that I have had the opportunity to cast so far in the ASL India Premiership. So, brilliant game. I had a blast. It did take a while though, you know, lots of delays because of internet issues and whatnot, but in the end it did pay off. So thank you guys for tuning in. Do tune in tomorrow as well, when we'll be having continuing the ASL India Premiership. 6:30 p.m. is when we go live at Hearthstone, 7 p.m. Dota 2, and then at 8 p.m. will be CSGO, brought to you by yours truly. That's it from our end. My name is Bleh. That's my nick. Some guys actually thought it was my real name. I'm very stupid or something, man. My name is Blay. Thank you for tuning in. It was a pretty fun game. I'm just going to go grab some dinner right now. You guys have fun. GG, well played. Go hard. You know, try hard. Go.